In this video we'll do a quick overview of some simple solving techniques. I will also show you some advanced ones, which will help you solve bigger puzzles. Look for clues that sum up to the whole range of the puzzle. In this case 5 plus 4 equals 9. We need a white cell between them, so we need 10 cells in total. When we have a clue which is bigger than half of the available cells, we can use the overlapping technique. The two extremes define an area which is always black. We can easily extend black cells which are on the edge of the puzzle to match the respective clue. Marking the completed clues will help you keep track of your progress. Check for completed rows or columns and mark the rest of the cells with X. Take a look at this row and the two possible extremes of the 5. There are two things we can deduce. Because of the black cell which is already on the row, the block cannot reach further than 5 cells away from it. The second thing is that two of the cells are always black. On this column you can see that both blocks can't fit in the top area, nor in the bottom area. This means that the 2 must be in the top area, and the 4 must be in the bottom one. The rest of this puzzle can be solved using the explained solving techniques. The next technique I want to show you is an advanced variation of the overlapping technique. You can take the two extremes, and if there are cells which always belong to the same block, then they must be black. The next technique is called joining. The second block is not part of the 2 because otherwise there will be no space for the 5. Both blocks are part of the 5, so we can join them. The next technique is called splitting. The cell in the middle cannot be black because it will form a block of 3. It must be white, so we can complete the row. The final technique I want to show you is called bordering. The first 7 cannot start from the top. If it does, the second 7 should also start from the top. And that would cause a contradiction for the 1. We can deduce that the top 2 cells of the first column are white. Now you are well armed with techniques. You should be able to crack any nonograms puzzle. And one general advice: never make a guess. Play only moves that you are 100% certain they are correct. In the next video I will show you how to make the most of the interface of www.puzzle-nonograms.com. I will show you all the settings, different modes and helpers. How to play on a desktop computer or on a mobile device. With a mouse, keyboard or a touchscreen.